We know that BRAF inhibitors work great in BRAF mutant melanoma, and that's been a major revolution in our field. However, there's some problems with BRAF inhibitor monotherapy. One problem is that resistance develops fairly quickly, and the progression-free survival is between 5 and 6 months, if you look at most BRAF inhibitor monotherapy trials. And also, the major side effect of BRAF inhibitor therapy is the hyperproliferative skin lesions, the cutaneous squamous cell carcinomas and papillomas and whatnot. And in preclinical models, it's been shown that if you add a MEK inhibitor to that, you could reduce the incidence of these secondary squamous cell carcinomas, and also that you can delay resistance from developing. So I think there's a compelling, scientific and clinical rationale. And if you look at biopsy studies, where people have been biopsied by Roger Loh and by others, you can see that about two-thirds of the time, resistance develops because of reactivation of the MAP kinase pathway. One-third of the time, it's something else, but two-thirds of the time, it's reactivation. So vertical inhibition, where you get two levels, makes sense. And so this trial is basically, it's a complex study, but the part that we are focusing on, Part C, is a randomized phase II trial with three arms: dabrafenib monotherapy, dabrafenib plus trametinib at a lower dose, and dabrafenib plus trametinib at a higher dose.